Christmas show.
Why?
It'll be just as ridiculous as the rest of them.
Fantastic, Mr. Fox, because he would get us out of some tricky situations, and he's very resourceful and resilient.
Voldemort. Well, Voldemort gets things done. He's not very nice, but you don't need to be. Nice Prime Minister is an absolute waste of time.
Dennis and Menace.
Horrid Henry
and Dennis and Menace. Yeah. It'd be a coalition.
It'd be like the Monster Raven Looting Party.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And then we'd come in and give advice to everyone as well. The world would be a better place.
Oh, I have to think hard about that. Atticus Finch. Safe pair of hands. Understanding. Strong.
Strong and stable.
Yeah. Oh, God!
At a time when our country's a bit divided, people have voted to leave or remain, you need somebody who understands that and can bring it back together. And so I'm going to choose Elizabeth Gaskell. I think she would be a brilliant, unifying Prime Minister for our country.
Hermione Granger. Definitely. I think Hermione Granger would make a great Prime Minister. She's smart, she's funny, and she's also best friends with Ron and Harry, so of course Hermione.
It would need to be Oliver Twist because he understood austerity and he understood love and he knew how to find it, and he was a man of the people.
At the moment he was extremely excited and overjoyed because his mother-in-law just died.
You have no idea of the grief I'm in while I write. I'm obliged to use an umbrella to keep the tears from running down on the paper.
It should be a woman, shouldn't it? I think women should start running the world up. I think it should be Anne from Persuasion by Jane Austen, because she is... It's the ultimate story about playing the long game. So she's so wise, she's so generous, she's so compassionate, she's so smart, she's so patient. And I think patience and wisdom is what we need in our world leaders.
The Queen in Alice in Wonderland, and she chopped everybody's heads off. Demand it and get it.